Oh my god, look at how messy my room is. Please ignore that. Anyways, hi guys. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. I have some products to show you guys that I like and I fucking hate. I'm gonna show you guys that, and if you are interested, keep on watching. So first thing I'm gonna show you are the palettes that I love, and I think I'm gonna show you just the products that I like first, and then I'll show you the ones that I don't like very much. But first of all, I have not been using this for very long. I don't really have anything to say about the shadows. Like, I like the shadows, but I haven't been using them for too long, so I don't think I really have a say on them yet. But so far, first impressions, they were super pretty. I'm actually wearing a couple colors from here on my eyes. But what I like mainly about this palette that I keep going back to is the blush and the highlighter. This blush is so just subtle and like a really like natural blush, like natural color, and I really like that because some of the blushes that I've used are really fucking pigmented, and I don't like that because I like building up blush. I don't want to just dip into the, you know, color and then put it on my face and there's just this big red dot on my face, you know? So these two, I really like blush, I really like, and the highlight is super pink. I'm wearing it right now, but it's like, it's really amazing. Really, really amazing. My second is Modern Renaissance. I've been using this for like a while now, but I would use it a lot in the beginning. See how it's not like super used up? Oh. Anyways, it's not super used up just because they're really powdery and very pigmented, so you just dip your brush a little bit and boom. But I'm really liking this palette because the colors blend so well and it's just, I don't know, look at that. Enough said. I mean, they're just so pretty and they last all day and it's just amazing. My third palette is the Naked Heat palette. I don't like Naked, I'm not gonna lie. I feel like all of their palettes are the same and I don't like that. This palette I feel is very different from what they do, and I was like, you know what, fuck it, I'm just gonna get it. I'm just gonna get it and see how it, you know, goes, and I love it. And the packaging is so pretty. So yeah, that is it for the palettes. So next are the lips. Kylie Cosmetics, of course. I don't actually have a lot to say about this liquid lipstick, but I did put it into the category of likes, just because it's not bad. Like, it's super nice. It's a really nice formula. This is Candy K. I love it. I mean, I don't wear it that often because it's actually kind of dark. Like, I didn't think it was gonna be that dark, but it's kind of dark on the lips when it dries, so kind of sus. But anyways, other than that, the Stila liquid lipsticks are my favorite. Absolutely my favorite. Super creamy, don't even know it's on your lips, it doesn't get crusty, it doesn't get gross. Like, I love it. I love this. Love this color, and it's the color that when it dries up, it's this color. So it's not sus at all. It shows you what you're gonna get, and I like that. But yeah, this is my absolute favorite liquid lipstick. I wear it all the time when I'm just like running out of the house. I'll wear this. I put this in my purse. It's gonna go in my purse right now. Also, next is the Better Than Sex mascara. I've only been using this for a couple weeks now, but I've been really liking it. I've been using this one the most out of all my mascaras. It's really, really heavy. I love the packaging. It's pink. And the writing is like, look at that. How would you not like that? Better Than Sex? I don't know about that, but it's still good. I love it. It feels expensive. It's heavy. It's really heavy. I could like lift some weights with this thing. But yeah, I'm liking it so far. I really am. Yeah. Okay, and next is the Stila, what are they called? Magnificent Metals. I didn't even remember what they were called. But yeah, these are so nice. I'm wearing it also right now. So yeah, I love these. They're so nice and they stay all day and so easy to apply. Look at this. This already comes with like a little brush, a little applicator. Look at that. You don't need a brush. You don't need to mess up your brushes. It's already got one. Next is eyeliner and brow dip. Dip brow. I'm losing my shit. I can feel it. So for the eyeliner, it's a tattoo liner by Kat Von D. I really like this. I got the brown just because I really like subtle liner. I used to wear black eyeliner like a lot, but I've just realized that my eyes aren't really good for eyeliner because I have really hooded lids. So I try to kind of stay away from liner. I've been trying to perfect it though, like trying to see what angles I should do to make eyeliner look good on me. I just can't do it though, and I get so frustrated whenever I can't do a good eyeliner. It's a disaster. So yeah, that one's really good. And the Anastasia Beverly Hills. Do I really have to talk like that? Cassie, you're making a fool of yourself. But this dip brow pomade is so good. The only thing that's kind of about it is that it dries actually pretty quick. Like if you don't do your eyebrows every single day, like 3 times a day, then it dries up super quick. I've had this for, I want to say, less than a year? Less than a year? Something like that? Something around that. And I just put oil in it. Okay, next is the Fit Me foundation. I feel like I take a deep breath before I even say anything. Like it sounds like I just ran a fucking marathon and I need to take a breath. Anyways, Fit Me foundation. Dewy and smooth. I like this one because it makes me feel dewy. It really does. I really like it. It's like, I've been using this for a long, long time. Like I used it in, I think, high school or middle school, I don't remember. And then I started using it again just recently. And I'm like, why did I ever stop using this? It's so good. My next foundation is Rainforest of the Sea. This is my absolute favorite. Number one foundation. I love it so much. It's not like full coverage, but I don't really need full coverage. I just need something to cover up my redness. And this is perfect. It's water-based and it's just beautiful on the skin. And it comes like in like this little, like that. See? I got like none left. I have to order some more or go get some more. But I love this. Favorite foundation in the entire world. And also, this Tarte Shape Tape is my favorite concealer slash highlighter, lightener. I think that's even what it says. Contour, concealer. I guess that's all it says. Light neutral is what I use. Well, what I've been using, but I think it might be a little dark, but they don't have a shade in between the last one I was using and this one, so it's kind of a dilemma. But you know what, I use this anyways because it does the job. It's good, it's okay, but I love it. It doesn't crease, it's just beautiful. Okay, for brushes, I really like the Morphe brushes. Love them, absolutely love them, but these ones, with the gold, I mean most of their brushes are just so nice, so pretty, and I love this brush. This one is the R0, I don't know, I just saw it, grabbed it, I was like, I'm buying this. But I love this because it like blends everything so nicely, and sometimes if I'm like on the go, I'll just bring this brush because I can use this for like anything, foundation, bronzer, concealer, I could use it for highlight, I could use it for blush, everything on the base. I could use this because I just want to blend everything out perfectly. And this is perfect. Sorry, I'm a little dirty, but another one of their brushes. I use this one for my blush. It's the Morphe R14 brush, obviously for blush, but I really like this. It's like just perfect to apply blush. I don't even know if this brush is even for that, but you know what, I use it for that. But damn. So the other brush that I use that I absolutely love is the Morphe Y19 brush. This is a blending brush. If I could marry a brush, it would be this one. Definitely would be this one. This is perfect for blending. Perfect. And I got like small lids, so I don't need like an extra brush. But this is really nice. I love this brush. I always use it. Always, always, always. If I could use just one brush in the entire world, it would be this one. For my base and everything. No, probably not that. But my eyes, yes, I love this. Okay, and my last one is this dirty ass sponge. So when I go to like Sephora and I see their sponges, I'm like, oh, you know what? I need a new sponge. And then I see the price tag and I'm like, oh, you know what? I don't need a new sponge. Because I'm not about to pay fucking $25 for one sponge. Are you kidding me? I've had this for like, what, a month now? And look at how dirty it is. I mean, yeah, I could just wash this and it'll probably come out, but still, like, they just get so ruined so quick. Why would I spend $25 on one sponge? That's super fucked up because it doesn't take that much to make a sponge, so I just feel like they're ripping us off, and it's like, wow, okay. I don't appreciate that. This shit was like a couple bucks. A couple bucks at Forever 21. Like, a couple bucks, yes, I will spend a couple bucks on sponge, and it's so squishy. Okay, next is face products and, you know, all that good shit. So first is the Jeffree Star Velour Lip Scrub. In Blue Raspberry Sucker. Oh my, like I wanna eat this, but it says you can't eat it, so I'm like, I wanna eat it so bad. But it says like you can't like replace it for a snack, which I find so, so funny. But it literally just smells like candy. And I like the fact that when you put on your lips, you can eat it right off your lips and it's so good. But, and I've owned a couple lip scrubs in my life, and this is by far the best. Next is this Derma-E Hydrating Night Cream. I love this so much. I haven't used all of it, but you don't need a lot. You do not need a lot. Just put your finger on there, dab it on there. It's so moisturizing and nice. Like, it makes my skin feel so, so good. And I have more, like, dry skin. I have normal to, you know, dry skin, oily skin, like all of the fucking above. But I really like this because my skin is more dry than it is like oily. So this is perfect. I put this on before bed and in the morning I just feel so hydrated, refreshed, and it's just amazing. Next is these Bior like deep cleansing pore strips. I got the one with the forehead and the nose strips. I love these. These are way better than any face mask that I've used. It is kind of a little painful to peel it off, but you know what? Beauty is pain, so deal with it. But yeah, I love these. These are my favorite. They get rid of blackheads. They get rid of all of your disgusting ass shit in your pores. And they just feel so like refreshing after, you know, after you take it off and then wash your face, it's like, oh my god, my face can breathe. Next, I have the Rainforest of the Sea Deep Dive Cleansing Gel. This is what I use to take off my makeup, and my makeup just comes off like that. And what's cool is I stopped using wipes, makeup wipes, because this kind of encouraged me to, you know, wash my face, because sometimes I would just take a makeup wipe and wipe off my eyes and my face and be like, okay, I'm gonna go to bed now. Bitch, you still have shit on your face. But love this stuff. Love, love, love. And it's not even expensive, which is cool. But Also for face stuff, I use this Mario Badescu. Yeah, probably. But it's drying lotion. This is really good for pimples. I definitely recommend this. Okay, now for products that I dislike and fucking hate. So, you've been watching my videos for a while now. You know that I fucking hate these brushes. They are from Makeup For You. And I hate them. I really do. Like, I'm sure if I tried, like, just to pull this off just a little bit, it would come off. I've had probably, like, 5 brushes break on me. These were super cheap, I'm not gonna lie, but I don't recommend getting them because, no. These are horrible. They're fucking horrible. Another product I really don't like is this Essence Say No to Redness little pen thingy. Oh my god, I'm getting it everywhere. So, I don't like this. This is really, it doesn't do anything with redness. It's just, it feels so cakey and disgusting. I can't stand it. I fucking hate this. Okay. This Tarte Maracuja oil. I don't really use oils that much. I actually, you know what, I never use oils, ever. So I don't really know, you know, too much about oils, but this smells like asshole. I don't like the smell of this whatsoever. I like to put it on my lips because, you know what, I bought it, I'm gonna use it, so I'm gonna suffer until this is gone. And I'm never gonna buy it again. But it smells horrible, and when I put it on my lips, I can smell it, and it's just gross. I would never dare put this on my face, but I don't really like it. I'm not liking it. I don't like the smell, so no. I'm just gonna set that down because that's glass. But, oh my god. So it's Makeup Forever Foundation, the HD, Ultra HD Foundation. Seriously sucks ass, okay? It smells like fish. It literally smells like they just got this out of the ocean, out of a fucking sea turtle's asshole, and put this shit in here. It's sea turtle shit, that's what it is. And it just smells horrible, but you know what? I'm just gonna have to wear this as well because, you know, this was 40 something bucks. This was almost $50, and it's not even a lot of product. What is that? That's it. That's all. I haven't used that much, so for almost $50 to smell like rotten pussy and shit, yeah, no, not fucking worth it. Do not get this foundation unless you want to smell like fish, but gross. Another foundation I don't like is this CoverGirl Clean Normal Skin foundation. I think that's what it's called. This one. This foundation smells really bad. It just reminds me of middle school. It does not smell good. When I put it on my face, it's like I just feel cakey. I feel gross. I feel ugh. I don't like this foundation at all. Okay. So for glues, oh my god, so I like the applicator for this Tarte Pro glue, clear glue. I like the applicator for this. I liked it at first. I was really liking it until, look at that. Let me just, you guys can't see that. Look at that. Oh my god, I'm a basic ass bitch. I'm putting my hand behind it. But it's got dry ass glue all over around it, and it's like sticky. I'm not even gonna say dry ass glue because it's sticky. It's gross. But I don't know if all, you know, containers or whatever the fuck they're in, packaging, is all like that because, okay, so this doesn't do that, but when I try to, you know, take a little bit out, it squirts out and it gets everywhere. This is the black one from, Star glue. I don't like this. I don't like any glue like this in packaging, and I don't like glue. I don't like eyelash glue because I feel like it gets everywhere. Like, am I supposed to wipe this off before I close it? Like, I shouldn't have to do that, you know? So for eyes, sorry, I'm like sitting everything behind me. So for eyes, I really don't like this Lorac Unzipped palette. I love the colors, I really do. Like, they're so, so cute, but they're not really pigmented. Like, when I put them on my eye, so I wore this, like, a couple times, a few times, and it doesn't last. it doesn't last. I've used different primers. Like I used the primer that it came with, and it didn't even last on my eyes. So it might be different for other people, but for me, it didn't work out. I might use it for like, you know, inner colors or whatever. If I'm just gonna go out real quick and I just need to put something on my face, then I'll use this. But I was really sad because I really wanted it like this, but I don't. So for lips, last but not fucking least. Actually, I know I have a few more things. So, real fucking quick, I'm gonna run through this. MAC lipsticks. I fucking hate matte lipsticks. MAC lipsticks. It's just disgusting. It's like, ugh. It's gross. I don't like these. This is like a darker color, but it's like crusty, musty ass. Okay. Coco by Kylie Cosmetics. This one in Damn Gina. This is a lip gloss. Oh my god, this is me losing my shit, by the way. But I love this color. I love everything about this, except the fact that I have to apply it so often. It comes off so quick. And I love lip glosses, but this is just, it doesn't last at all. So I don't know if that's just with all lip glosses. I don't own that many lip glosses, but this is sad. I really like the color. I really like everything about it, except I gotta apply it every 2 seconds. Okay, this lip booster. This is not a surprise to you, most of you who have seen my videos. I don't like this. I don't. It does not boost your lips. I don't know what the fuck it's trying to say. I don't like it, but it's clear, so that's the reason why I use it. I need to get a clear lip gloss. So that is it, guys. That is my likes and loves and dislikes and fucking hates. So if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and comment and subscribe, but comment any videos you want me to do, if you want me to do this look, if you want me to buy any palette that's out there or any product out there and you want me to try it out, I will be willing to do that, just as long as it's not like $1,000. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching.